Okay, video two for this day, Thursday, March 7th, 2019, 8:07 a.m. Pacific time. Thank you, Lord. I'm gonna come over here to Matthew 8, which is a really good chapter in the New Testament in the Gospel of Matthew for healing. Okay. Matthew 8, this is King James Version, public domain. When he, Jesus, was come down from the mountain, great multitudes followed him. And behold, there came a leper and worshipped him. Now, leprosy, as far as I know, is incurable. Do your own research on that. And behold, there came a leper and worshipped him, saying, Lord, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. And Jesus put forth his hand and touched him, saying, I will, be thou clean. And immediately his leprosy was cleansed. And Jesus saith unto him, See, thou tell no man, but go thy way, show thyself to the priest, and offer the gift that Moses commanded for a testimony unto them. And when Jesus was entered into Capernaum, there came unto him a centurion, beseeching him, and saying, Lord, my servant lieth at home sick of the palsy, grievously tormented. And Jesus saith unto him, excuse me, I will come and heal him. And the centurion answered and said, Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldest come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my servant shall be healed. These are great scriptures. I encourage you to meditate on these scriptures and on any of the Bible, but particularly healing. We send the word only for Alex Trebek, Lord. I am not worthy that thou shouldest come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my servant shall be healed. For I am a man under authority, having soldiers under me, and I say to this man, Go, and he goeth, and to another, Come, and he cometh, and to my servant, Do this, and he doeth it. When Jesus heard it, he marveled and said unto them that followed, Verily, I say unto you, I have not found so great faith, no, not in Israel. And I say unto you, that many shall come from east and west, and shall sit down with Abraham and Isaac and Jacob in the kingdom of heaven. But the children of the kingdom shall be cast out into outer darkness. There shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth. And Jesus said unto the centurion, Go thy way, and as thou hast believed, so be it done unto thee. Now you can apply this not only to healing, but you can apply it to other things, okay, in your life that you're crying out to God for, okay? But in this particular instance, it's go thy way as thou hast, and as thou hast believed, so be it done unto thee. And his servant was healed in the selfsame hour. And when Jesus was come into Peter's house, he saw his wife's mother laid and sick of a fever. And he touched her hand, and the fever left her, and she arose and ministered unto them. When the even was come, this is Matthew chapter 8 in the book of Matthew. When the even was come, they brought unto him many that were possessed with devils, and he cast out the spirits with his word, and healed all that were sick. All that were sick, okay? That it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by Esaias the prophet, saying, Himself took our infirmities. Remember, in the first video of today, I was talking about Isaiah 53. Himself took our infirmities and bare our sicknesses. Now, when Jesus saw great multitudes about him, he gave commandment to depart to the other side. And a certain scribe came and said unto him, Master, I will follow thee whithersoever thou goest. And Jesus said unto him, The foxes have holes, and the birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man hath nowhere to lay his head. And another of his disciples said unto him, Lord, suffer me first to go and bury my father. But Jesus said unto him, Follow me, and let the dead bury their dead. And when he was entered into a ship, his disciples followed him. And behold, there arose a great tempest in the sea, insomuch that the ship was covered with the waves, but he was asleep. Do you have some storms in your life? And his disciples came to him and awoke him, saying, Lord, save us, we perish. And he said unto them, Why are you fearful, O ye of little faith? I confess, Lord, I am little of faith so much of the time, Lord. I confess, we confess before you, Lord, that we are small of faith so many times, Father Jesus. And he saith unto them, Why are ye fearful, O ye of little faith? Then he arose and rebuked the winds and the sea, and there was a great calm. We rebuke the winds and the sea. We rebuke the storm right now in Jesus' name. We rebuke the storm, the storms in our lives, the fear in Jesus' name. In our country, in Jesus' name. But the men marveled, saying, What manner of man is this, that even the winds and the sea obey him? And when he was come into to the other side of the country of the Gergesenes, there met him two possessed with devils. Now, I'm going to stop right there, only because it's a little bit longer than I want to make this video. Honestly, it's not because I don't want to go on and on. Okay, so you read the rest of Mark 8 and just keep it simple. Just believe him. Simply believe God. Okay, that's all you have to do is believe him. I gotta do something here. I gotta switch the TV so it doesn't turn off. Nancy Pelosi's on there talking. I don't listen to the Democrats. I mean, rarely. Because they're just not full of nonsense, okay? Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for this day, Lord. This is going to be a good day. You know, by faith, it's going to be a good day. I pray for everybody's safety and healing and provision. In Jesus' name, amen.